my chair. Gorilla must be daydreaming out there.
You didn't have a chair to sit in?
No. Good morning, everybody. How you doing? Oh, there it is. There's my chair. Gorilla, what did I tell you? That my buttock should never hit this other chair, ever. Jackie, don't hit Gorilla in the head. His hair will fall out. Smacking him in the head.
Too late.
Too late is right. Good morning, Robin.
Good morning to you.
And good morning, everybaba.
Gorilla's been out there with that new intern. He can't think about your chair.
Is that right? Is that right?
I didn't hear what she said.
You've been out there with the new intern?
No.
Oh, please. You were entertaining her all morning.
Yeah.
I was entertaining her all morning. There you go.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that. You're single.
There you go.
Yeah. Go for it. I would, believe me. I'm going to go for it. I'm married. All right. You might be a homo, Gorilla.
I think so. Yeah, maybe I am.
I was just yelling at Gorilla in the other room.
Yeah, he started crying?
No, I just said, remember that redhead that was up here that wanted to have sex with Gorilla?
Yeah.
And she was on the pay-per-view. She worked the penis tote board.
Right.
And Gorilla's like, well, I wasn't interested. Meanwhile, she was really hot.
Oh, he came to me the day before the pay-per-view.
Yeah.
Or whatever day he was supposed to actually have sex with her.
Yeah.
And he said, Robin, what's supposed to happen tomorrow? And I said, what are you talking about?
Do whatever you want.
I'm supposed to have sex with that girl.
Yeah, he's looking for someone to force him to do it. You're an idiot. Talk into the microphone, you idiot. No, you know what's funny about him? Like, Gary walks in this morning and goes, boy, I don't know, that redhead, she had kind of a cheesy ass. So I go, you know what? I can't wait for the day you don't work on this show anymore.
Yeah,
and your wife
and
leaves you.
I'd have done it, though.
Let me explain to you.
You guys
have all gone insane. You see beautiful women walking around here because, you know, a lot of them are models and strippers and stuff. A girl like that walks in. That's the kind of girl, Delabate, that in high school, if you met her in a bar, you would have been kissing her feet, just hoping she'd look at you.
Right.
And the same with the Gorilla over there.
Gorilla.
I'm surprised that he didn't partake. I really am.
Yeah, I am, too. Come on, you cheesy ass. Show him the pictures of Gina, and the Gina took advantage of the redhead.
Gina. So Gina got her.
Look at the two of them. She just sent us pictures of the redhead and her getting it on.
So they had fun after the party.
Yeah, that Gorilla could have been in on it.
You could have been the third.
Idiot.
Right. Man.
Don't wait, the good one's coming up right here. This is the one that's going to kill him.
This is the one I like.
That's a good one.
Wow.
Oh, hold on, there you go. Wait. You ready? You ready? There it is.
I got that all on the backstage tape. Call 1-800-52-STERN, 3995.
Look at his eyes. Here's a real
18
one.
18 or over.
Something like that?
Yeah, that's definitely my favorite shot, that one.
Here's a good one.
Oh, man.
How could you not call? How could you not go out with her, man? What are you, homo?
I talked to her.
What?
I've been talking to her.
China got into her pants in 3 seconds,
yeah,
idiot.
What is your problem?
She already did. She already thinks you're a wimp. I mean, she told me as much because she said, what's wrong? And she told me the day of the show, what's wrong with Gorilla? I'm chasing him all around. He doesn't want it. I said, I don't know.
Yeah, I'd want it. Give it to me, man.
What was your problem there?
I don't know.
Was there somebody else you were interested in?
Is somebody else knocking on your door? The dance card?
Can I tell you what happened? My perception of what happened?
Probably one of the guys said, oh, I wouldn't do it.
No. Steve was running around talking to a lot of the girls.
Oh, and he thought he was going to get them, yeah.
You know, and I'm not saying he thought he was going to get them, but he might, you know, he might have said, hey, I get, you know,
I don't want the redhead.
No, right, no, I get the blondes.
That's not what happened at all.
Meanwhile, you got nobody. You got Mr. Left Hand.
He kept hanging out at that hotel. I think he really did think he had a chance with somebody else.
All of my interns think that they're going to get all the beautiful girls that show up on this show, and then they get freaked out when they don't. Like, that's what happened to Ganji. Yep. Ganji had a nice girlfriend, Jen, and all of a sudden he started hanging around here. He sees all these strippers and models, and he goes, ooh.
What am I doing? Tying myself down.
Perfect example. He came to that that big photo shoot for your book.
Oh, yeah.
Right? He got a bunch of numbers.
No one ever went out with
calls him. They, you know, they call him back in a month.
Yeah.
I'm busy. You know, they string him along in case they could use him.
Grillo, you know who you should go out with? Ganji. Two of you guys should take. You know, Gina's more of a man than you are.
She knows how to close the deal.
She sure does. Look at those pictures. Gina sent us pictures of herself with the redhead.
Uh-huh.
Plus, I have the video. That's 10 times better.
You mean these pictures aren't even from...
That's from Gina's dressing room.
Right, before the party.
Yeah, I have the actual party. They'd already been familiar with one another.
I see.
Gina's boyfriend took the pictures. He's got a good job.
While this was going on, the redhead told me Gorilla knocked on the door.
Yeah.
And the boyfriend said, go away.
No, yeah, Tony goes, who is it? I said, it's Steve. Is Autumn there? He goes, no. I said, all right. And I left.
And this is what, and this is what was happening. Uh-huh.
All right. And I left.
If you want to see the action, 1-800-52-STERN. I'll do a couple of plugs here for the tape. Just put it on sale a couple of days ago. $39.95 and poster. In, I think there's going to be a poster in it, too. I haven't shot that yet. Because I had a meeting with Miss Howard Stern yesterday.
Oh, yes? And what did you determine? She was out of here so fast, I thought. Did she get to see Howard?
No, she saw. Yeah, well, please. It was a very brief meeting. She looked great, though. Miss Howard Stern is really good-looking. God, she wore a dress where her stomach was, like, exposed.
I didn't see what she was wearing.
Yeah.
I saw her son. I mean, her son. Her husband and her daughter.
Yeah, that was kind of a bummer.
He goes everywhere with her, doesn't he?
Yeah, I know. It was like, I thought she'd show up on her own. She shows up with her husband.
Does he have a job?
I don't know. Yeah, according to them, he does. Yeah.
Did you know he was shot in the head?
Yeah, she told me that.
What?
He was shot in the back of the ear, and it came out the other side of his ear, and you can't even tell.
Yeah, from where he worked.
What kind of job is that?
I don't know. He wasn't doing a really good job, I guess. So they shot him. No. He got robbed or something.
Target?
No, he got robbed.
He works in downtown Brooklyn.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Yeah.
I think his job now is going to be handling her money.
Yeah. But she's making appearances and junk. Yeah,
did you straighten her out? Did you tell her what to do?
Yeah. I got to talk to you about that.
It's already taken care of, actually.
Oh, really?
Yes, she's been hooked with representation.
Good. Okay. I had a long meeting with Miss Howard Stern in 1994.
It couldn't have been that long.
Yeah, it was 5 minutes. So she sat down and right away was like, I don't want to disgrace the Howard Stern show. I want to make sure I clear everything with you guys. And I go, I said, honey, there ain't much you could do to disgrace this show.
Did you see that contest?
But no, she had the right attitude. She didn't want to do anything stupid that would piss us off. So I just said to her, look, I said, you can go out and do all the appearances you want. You can do whatever you want. You want to make a poster. Just, understand that you can't just call up here anytime and advertise what you're doing. That
we're not going to be a part of that.
Yeah, we're not, we'd love to, if we're talking to you, you're certainly welcome to plug and stuff like everyone else does. But, you can't represent to anyone that you own this station and own the airwaves and all that kind of thing. She's real cool and she looks real good and she'll be an excellent representative of the Howard Stern Show. I have no qualms about sending her out. I was too embarrassed to bring up whether or not she'd pose nude for us for our painting session.
I'll call later.
Yeah, you set that up.
Well, that's terrible.
Yeah, I don't know if I feel right. I did close it, but I don't know. I don't know.
I think she was just saying yes, yes, yes to anything. Yes.
The problem with her is, well, she lifted up her dress for me in the meeting so I could see her garters and stuff.
I imagined that, like, it would have been, you could have asked her to do anything, and she probably would have, because you're Howard Stern, and you made her,
And she wasn't aggressive enough.
But I think, like, if you would have said, let's go over to this couch.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, Coco, let's go over to this couch.
Yeah, let's go over and
exactly.
Let's go over and have some fun. Believe me, I was tempted. She's hot. She is cute.
I can't believe that she has a kid. I really can't.
Do you know she's only 22?
She's 22?
She's 22 years old.
Really?
When did she get married?
My mouth hit the floor.
I'm just surprised. I'm not saying her husband's an ugly guy, but he kind of does look like Corky from, what is it called? Life Goes On?
Life Goes On.
I couldn't look him in the face yesterday.
Doesn't he kind of look like him?
He does.
You know what's great fun is I was walking along the hall, and as you were going by, I saw her sitting in there,
Yeah.
And you get ready to walk in and say hello, and
the husband's
just,
there.
As you walk in, her husband's there, and you just say hello completely different.
Yeah, I know.
It's like, hey,
yeah, it sucks. Yeah. You can't have any fun with her.
Well, you say he looks like Corky. Yesterday I saw him driving a car, and you do. You look at him and go, should he be driving?
Does he have to get a license? But then it was like, when you're meeting with her and stuff, her husband and her kid's there, so throws a little damper on it.
Well, I thought she was coming alone. I thought you had made that clear.
Well, I met with her alone for like 5 minutes.
Uh-huh.
And then, it's just shocking because she's so pretty and, he's like a regular looking guy.
First of all,
he's not
like
even regular.
He's bald as an eagle.
First of all, you start with the age difference right away.
Looks like her father.
Then you go to the balding part.
Right.
And then you just go to like the
paunch. The body.
The paunch.
Yeah, right.
And then you're like, what's going on?
I know. He's lucky. He lucked out. Yeah, it's not right. It isn't right.
He's got like this Svengali thing over her, this hold over her. Like
it's called being her husband.
No, come on.
Your wife listens
much worse than that.
Does your wife listen to you the way she listens to him?
My wife doesn't listen to a thing I say.
Exactly.
That's what we're talking about. I saw him coaching her.
Yeah.
in the whatever that is, the green room there.
Really?
He was sitting there, and he's got his fingers, and she's shaking it in her face.
Really?
He's sitting there listening intently. You know,
really?
Yes.
Really? Jeez.
And you heard the way she was on the radio. Oh, no, he's the greatest guy. You
I
don't know
she
him.
Digs him. She digs him. Oh, what are you going to do? Well, she's Miss Howard Stern, 1994. She's our prize gashish. Maybe she's hypnotized.
I think maybe that's what the finger shaking's all about.
So, you know, like a lot of people are contacting her. They wanted to do promotional appearances and...
They should book the husband, too, just to see what he
looks like. Yeah, that's kind of the part of it, I think.
It's like a Burns and Allen thing.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, they're kind of like having high hopes about this Howard Stern thing because, like, you know, he wants to stop working and retire, I guess, and... You know, they're waiting for her to bring in the mother load. And I just said, you know, don't get carried away.
That's right. She's the one.
Yeah. But she definitely listens to him. Now, he's either well hung or has a great punch. Good left hook. So, that's that. I don't think he has any coke.
You just looked at him and you said, no coke.
Yeah, I sized him up.
Definitely no coke.
No coke, maybe big penis, possibly. Definitely looks powerful, like a good left hook. He could definitely kick my ass. Then again, so could anybody. So, that's that. So I had that meeting yesterday, and then I was looking at naked pictures of Gina and thinking about the fact that Gorilla could have been with the redhead that Gina was with, and Gorilla just passed on it because these interns have lost their minds. Either that or they're homosexuals.
Well, I heard all kinds of strange things about Gorilla during that.
Oh, really? What did you hear? What did you hear?
I heard that he was having a very tough time getting through that week.
What week?
Are you kidding? I had a great time.
The pay-per-view week, the week he was out there in New Jersey.
Oh, really? Why?
I heard these rumors.
Well, I heard that he was, you know, first he's running around there trying to get the girls all day long.
Yeah.
And then later,
yeah.
He was on the phone crying home.
Crying?
Yeah.
I wasn't crying.
Crying home?
To his girlfriend.
Ex-girlfriend.
You idiot. You're an idiot. You still calling your ex-girlfriend?
Yeah, we just like call and argue and...
I love you. I couldn't get anyone else.
Yeah.
That's not the case at all.
Oh, now I'm remembering now.
Yeah.
I had a room.
Yeah.
Can I stay in your room? I got no room. Can I stay in your room? I said, sure, you know?
Yeah.
So he goes out and gets loaded, and I'm trying to get to sleep. I got to be up early in the morning.
Jackie finally mad at a drunk.
He comes in at 2 o'clock. We're sharing the hotel rooms, you know, so there's a phone in the middle.
Right.
So we're a foot apart. And he comes in at 2 in the morning, and he thinks he's dialing quietly.
Oh,
all of a
my.
Hello. Oh, no. Oh, do you miss me? Do you think? And I'm trying to say.
No.
I swear to God, I was saying, for once in my life, I don't have that little stupid tape recorder.
Yeah, right.
I would have given up. You guys would have
died.
Oh,
my God.
Do you miss me? I miss you a lot. Do you miss me?
Oh, no.
I swear on my mother.
I was arguing with her.
Man. Oh, yeah.
Like an argument.
Yeah, some argument.
Do you think about
me? They're arguing about whether he
misses her. Do you think about me a lot? I think about you.
Oh, man.
You don't remember.
Oh, yeah, and so are you, Jackie. Oh, yeah, right.
Jackie was not loaded during the week. I happen to know that. He had a couple of beers. That was it.
That doesn't load Jackie.
I thought Jackie acted actually very professional during pageant week. I couldn't believe it.
Jackie won just by not having any stories told about her. He
might
not have done anything.
Yeah, and Jackie spent all week at the hotel. I still think something must have happened.
Everybody knew him.
I know Jackie.
It was very tough.
I know Jackie was propositioned, but I heard he turned it down.
It was very tough.
Yeah.
It was the Star Wars bar.
Yeah,
I
know.
It was unbelievable. And we really.
Jackie would go down every night to the bar. You see, all the girls were staying at one hotel during pageant week. So Jackie would go down every night to the bar and sit there and have a couple of beers waiting for something to happen.
And they all think that we had total influence on who won, too. So it wasn't just like that we were from the Howard Stern Show. We were from the Howard Stern Show and could affect whether or not they got $50,000.
Right. So Jackie, this is Jackie's dream come true.
This is a candy shop.
Yeah.
Better tie me up.
Yeah, Jackie's sitting and drinking for free, and then the girls come walking through the hotel, and then all of a sudden they're nude in the hotel, in the bar, piercing each other.
Guys are lined up handing me free drinks. I couldn't buy a drink.
Yeah, I mean, it was unbelievable. It was Jackie, and
Jackie
of course,
couldn't do anything.
And Jackie was propositioned. Some of the girls said, oh, I'm so bored. Some of the real good-looking ones, and Jackie turned them down.
Yeah.
Evidently, that's what
I
hear.
Sitting there with the producer, you know, we're going over the show, and they see us like,
Oh, boy. Yeah, of course, you guys put yourself in the bar where you know everyone will be.
Of course, they can't work in a room.
Absolutely.
You had to torture yourself a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
Oh, please.
A stupid gorilla's calling his girlfriend.
Yeah,
who you broke up with because she was giving you a hard time.
Do you miss me? I miss you.
Oh, gorilla once was on the air, and he says to one of the girls, I think you're really pretty. His girlfriend calls up and starts yelling at him, and he broke up with her.
Yeah.
He said, forget it. He said, this is ridiculous. I just said a girl was pretty. So now you're on the phone, I miss you.
I still talk. I didn't.
You're a pussy,
no,
man.
No.
You're a big pussy. You could have had that redhead. What's wrong with you?
I don't. Nothing, man.
Yeah, nothing. Just a pussy.
All right.
Pull in your pants, man. I want to check and see if you're a woman.
You could have been in the contest. Maybe you were eligible for the...
Hey, you're Miss Howard Stern, 1994. You're our prize gashish. Hey, speaking of interns, where's that imbecile, Stuttering John?
What did he do?
I'm reading in the newspaper. You know, I guess evidently the record company is putting out press releases about his new record coming out.
Uh-huh.
Evidently, it must be close to the time that the record's coming out.
And what happened?
Well, what?
What'd I do?
What did you do?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you right now what you did. In a rush?
No, I'm not in a rush. Can I pull up a chair?
What?
Go ahead.
He must be comfortable.
Hey, your record company put this out. Howard Stern's intrepid celebrity interviewer, Stuttering John Melendez, is recording an album for Atlantic. This has been going on for 3 years now.
Yeah.
It's due out in April.
Yeah. April?
I thought it was February. I'm going to get old waiting for this album.
Well, you think the music's going to be a little dated by the time it comes out?
I hope not.
It's going to sound like listening to a Blood, Sweat, and Tears album.
Really?
He hasn't done an interview in 6 months.
No. No, you haven't done anything for us.
Yes, I have.
What'd you do?
Tom Hanks. That was
a month ago?
It's not my fault.
Our sources say Atlantic Records is ready to pour some money into promoting Stuttering John's rock band, including backing a national tour beginning in March.
Oh, good. John won't be here.
Excellent.
Oh, no.
So we have your permission then to use the Tourette's guy to go out and do interviews?
No, this is news to me. But
oh, okay.
Go ahead.
One object to get some attention for the record. Videos are planned, too. Stern could give John's music career a real jump by appearing on his video, but he won't, says a publicist. You never asked me to be in your video.
I have nothing to do with this.
Well, why don't you get your record company together, you know? I mean, what kind of thing is that?
No, I don't even know anything about this, I swear.
But why don't you?
I don't even know how they would get a story like that.
I see.
Maybe from you?
You do, Fred? How would they get a story?
No, that was...
I said I do.
Oh.
You know who I think put that in the paper?
Who?
John's publicist.
John has a publicist.
Yes, it's he looks a lot like your publicist.
The one who
Dan Flores?
Would you hire my publicist?
I mean, Atlantic hire your publicist.
Do me a favor. Get Dan Flores on the phone. Tell him to leave my name out of stupid... Tell him just to leave it out.
You sure you never mentioned anything like this, John?
No, I swear. The only thing I ever asked was the alarm notes.
No, Morse code. SOS. Help.
No, I promise. I didn't say anything.
What?
Well, you certainly said it to me.
I said what to you? What did I say to you?
I would really like, how would you direct my video?
Oh, yeah, direct my video, but that was a long time ago.
Yeah,
and then,
I directed your video. Hire a director to direct
your video. Yeah, and I asked and you said no.
Get Marty Callner or somebody. He's looking for work.
I wouldn't say anything like that.
Huh?
I'm a good guy.
Marty Callner did the Aerosmith video. I thought he did a good job with them.
Yeah?
Yeah. Who's that girl in the Aerosmith video? The one they use every damn time they make a video. She must be dating someone in Aerosmith like Steven Tyler.
Cute.
Yeah, because how does she get into every video?
I didn't know.
Well, she's only done the two, right?
No, she's done three now.
Three?
Yeah, three.
She's like their mascot.
Yeah.
Well, she must be working for them.
She's hot. God, she's hot. What's her name, Robin?
I don't know her name, but she's in that movie, The Crush.
Mm. Man. They ought to get her for Beverly Hills 90210.
Well, you know, the rumor is Drew Barrymore.
Yeah, forget her.
You don't want her.
No. Screw that. Get the girl from the Aerosmith video. Boy, they should let me cast that show. I get rid of all those girls. Put in some new ones.
Except for Shannon. You'd keep her.
Yeah, I like her. I don't care how difficult she is. I can handle her. I'll get her to show up on the set.
No matter what her money demands?
Nah, she needs to be tamed like a puppy. She's got to be broken. All right, dickheads, get out of here. I'm ready to do my show. Stuttering John and Gorilla. Go for it, Gorilla. You don't like that redhead, huh?
I think, therefore, I damn.
You think what?
She's a nice person. I have no problem with her. Just she lives out in Jersey, and it's just hard.
Well, I don't get that. She lives out in Jersey.
Geographically undesirable.
She lives out in Jersey. She lives in Alaska. I'd go visit her.
Kansas.
I know. Jersey. These guys, I always hear that.
Fort Lee.
She lives all the way in Jersey.
I don't have a car. I can't.
$3
pole.
Dude, I'd invite her to go meet
a bus or the PATH train.
I tell you, I'd walk to her house.
$3 pole.
She's hot, man. You don't think she's hot?
Yeah, I think she's very pretty.
I think
she's dot.
I think
I got to take a break.
Oh, honey, I miss you.
All right, Gorilla.
I wasn't thinking about the lesbian with
you. I swear.
So Gorilla was in your room drunk, making phone calls to that girlfriend that he doesn't see anymore?
You know, I was trying to be a good guy and just lied there. And I'm telling you, he was on and checked the hotel record. He was on the phone for a half hour. Finally, I said, Gorilla.
I'm trying to sleep.
Give me a break. Yeah.
Seriously, Jackie's like a head writer and stuff. I mean, aren't you nervous about pissing him off by making phone calls?
No, he's my pal. And but he was call up and say, hello, honey, I'm thinking about you.
He's
good
my
night.
Pal.
No,
everyone
no,
is Jackie's
like
pal.
He likes
pal.
I love the kid. No,
I know if I asked Jackie if I could use his room for the night, he would throw me out.
You wouldn't let him.
I'm not his pal.
You can afford your own.
You get your own room, you bastard.
You don't even need my room.
Yeah.
No, but I mean, you know what it is? It went around in circles for about the fourth time. I was like,
right.
Enough.
Right.
You know, he was loaded. He didn't know what he was doing.
Right,
you know?
Right.
I miss you. Did I say that?
I miss you. You call your girlfriend at 2 in the morning and tell her you miss her?
All right, I did. All right.
What did I do? He didn't say I miss you as much as.
It was.
Are you thinking about me?
No.
What are you so insecure that you have to hold on to her? I thought you broke up with her.
That's not the case, though.
What is it, Baba Booey?
No, I was going to say that guy John Ailes from MTV is on the phone. He knows who that MTV chick is.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, her name. Well, he'll tell you who
Who's John Ailes?
He does a lip service show.
Oh, that guy?
Yeah.
Well, he'll do anything to get on this show.
He really has been trying.
She was on the Jon Stewart show.
Oh, was she?
Yeah.
That Jon Stewart show is pretty bad.
I wanted to
date. Isn't it, Robin? Have you seen it?
I haven't seen it since you were on it.
Yeah, evidently since I was on it, it got real bad. You know what it is? He's just like a... I don't know. He was sitting in William Shatner's lap, and he was trying to do like a hugging thing with Shatner, but it just was like really uncomfortable to look at.
He like really drools over the guests. Like,
yeah.
Overly, too much.
Just, like you and your girlfriend?
Yeah. When you call her at night? Hey, John.
Yeah.
So who is that girl in the Aerosmith video?
Her name's Alicia Silverstone.
And is she going out with one of the guys in Aerosmith?
No. She's young. Really young.
Really?
Steve Tyler's married, I think, as a matter of fact.
No, Steve Tyler, I think, dumped his wife.
I don't know what state he's in.
Yeah. He's got a daughter that's about Alicia's age. I think the word is they're going to do another one.
His daughter's a model.
Yeah.
Phoebe or something. BB. BB Tyler.
Not she's, Kate. Tyler.
Yeah, she's real hot. But so this girl, Alicia?
Alicia.
Why is she in every Aerosmith video?
I don't know. They think she's cool.
Yeah.
So do you?
Yeah, I think she's awesome, but I just can't imagine why they put her
they
in every
spread
video.
They ought to her to other groups.
She's more a member of the band than the drummer. I don't even know the drummer's name. Now I know Alicia's name.
Alicia.
She can keep a beat.
Yeah, she sure can. Right over here with Uncle Howie.
Hey, good job on the pay-per-view.
Thank you. Yeah, we had fun doing it.
Huh?
We had fun doing it.
Well, God.
You want to get the video, dude. We got all the backstage, everything that has been declared illegal in Newark.
How many copies can I buy, maximum?
You can buy whatever you want.
We have no limit.
We have no limit. There's plenty available. 1-800-52-STERN.
52-STERN.
$39.95, and you got to be 18 or older, which you are.
How do you know that?
Well, it's obvious you're about a 40-year-old guy trying to act like a 20-year-old. No,
yeah,
all right.
At least you're good-hearted about it.
Of course. All right, thanks.
Oh, man.
What do you want?
Well, thanks for the info, Steve.
Yeah,
That guy will do anything to get on the show. You never even said, I want to say, Gary did a great job. Didn't you think Gary did a good show?
That's the guy.
Nothing to say.
That's the guy from MTV's lip service. They keep advertising it as the last season, so I think he's out of there after
really?
In this season, yeah. That show is the worst show.
You think advertising it as the last season will make people watch?
I don't know.
Like they don't want to miss the last episode?
Every time I tune in, I want to watch it, but I don't know. There's nothing exciting to me about watching a bunch of kids lip sync to songs and then speeding up the record. That really annoys me. I think I'd like the show better.
Yeah, the only time I watched it all the way through was when Gary was on it those two times. It is an annoying show.
No, I couldn't even watch it with Gary. I thought Gary even made it more annoying.
Well, I kept watching to see how goofy he was going to get with his ratings.
You might be right. My biggest problem was dancing at the end.
Yeah.
But, you know, talking about that Jon Stewart show.
Yeah.
You know, the big buzz on that thing is now, which I can't believe,
yeah.
They're going to move it to late night. and he's going to go, you know, he's going to start competing with Conan and Letterman and all those guys. And I'm just like, what?
Yeah.
And you should hear how they talk about it.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to move to late night. It's going to make a big, you know, it's going to make a big impact.
I think so. I think it's going to really
Conan
change.
Conan better be shaking in his boots.
Conan is shaking in his boots, but not from that. You know, Conan's rating is below a one now?
No.
Yeah.
Stop.
Is that amazing?
Is that possible?
He is not up against anything, and it's below a one. They don't know what to do with him.
The test pattern is beating him.
So what NBC is thinking is they'll move Greg Kinnear into that slot, and it's like, oh, boy, he'll get below a .5.
Infomercials beat him.
I think Conan would be better than Greg Kinnear.
You know what's weird about all this late night? You know, everyone's been talking about me going into late night television and stuff. And now they're saying I'm not going to be late night television. They don't know what I'm doing. And believe me, I don't know what I'm doing. But I'm reading this article the other day by a guy named, they interviewed a guy named Don Ohmeyer. Do you know who he is?
He's an executive from one of the networks,
NBC.
Right?
NBC.
Yeah.
We spoke to him?
Yeah, we did speak to him once. He called in on the show once because we were talking about something. He corrected us. He called from his car.
Is that right?
I don't remember talking
Somebody
to him.
Somebody was here and called him.
That was Belzer.
Belzer, that's right.
He called Don Ohmeyer?
We only got an answering machine.
Oh. Well, anyway, they interview this guy, Don Ohmeyer, who is the NBC West Coast president.
He's the president of the West Coast of NBC.
Yeah, I don't know who the president of the East Coast is.
I didn't know NBC head coast.
Yeah, who knew? Anyway, he says, they say, well, what do you think? Will Howard Stern be the guy in late night? Could he work on television? Now, listen to an answer that means nothing. He says, you know, you listen to him, you laugh, you feel bad about laughing. Now, that I don't understand. I think Howard is maybe the greatest promoter of our time. I mean, 400,000 people who pay $40 a head for lesbian ice sculptors. P.T. Barnum could never grow $16 million on lesbian ice sculptors. Okay, so it's a put-down. You know, he's bad-mouthing me. Then he says, but self-promotional wizardry may not be enough for the mainstream. I think Howard would have a very difficult time coming on night after night and keeping the edge he has and stay within the bounds of where you have to stay in network broadcasting, Ohmeyer says. Now think about that statement. He's commenting on whether or not I could, you know, be a late-night host.
Yes.
He says, well, I don't know if Howard could do this night after night after night. Now, here I am, a guy who's been doing a radio show for 16 years.
Day after day.
No, for 5 hours a day minimum.
Right, but that's what I'm saying. It's day after day, and it's 5 hours. An hour of television is nothing.
And I compete with tons of guys.
All over the country, guys you can't even see or hear.
Right. And I'm number one everywhere, and this guy doesn't know whether I could hold up on a daily basis. Could you imagine? This guy's the vice president, the president or something.
Of the West Coast.
The West Coast.
He wasn't. They wouldn't give him the whole thing because he's not that bright.
I read this garbage. I go out of my mind. I say, you know, I said, who has a better track record at proving longevity than me? Nobody. This guy's paid to know something, and he knows nothing.